The colour should not be allowed to dry out completely to do the picking out. Do this when it is semi-dry and has lost its wet look.
We'll be right back.
Now, after another firing, more colour is added to the trunks of trees and stone. Now the angle of the bridge is clearly seen. More green brown is laid on and then picked back to give the effect of middle distance trees. Thank you. Mixing of the colours is of basic importance. Gently grinding with the palette knife, with the addition of fat oil and aniseed, and a touch of glycerin to produce the right consistency. White enamel is used on the dress to bring out the highlights, but be very cautious with the use of white. It can produce a violent highlight. Thank you. is no way of getting ceramic effects such as this in one go. It is not like oil painting. There are no shortcuts in producing a fine ceramic hand-painted vase. The painting firings are now complete, and the vase is ready for gilding. Preferably use burnishing gold, and do not thin it down. Apply the gold evenly, and keep separate brushes for it. Keep them suspended in an airtight jar, even with a little thinner in the bottom, but not touching the brush. When gilding up to the colour, do not let the line of gold go over the colour, as it will alter the texture of the gold. Work the gold away from the colour until you have the gold running smoothly, and then you can use larger, broader brushes for the larger areas that you can load up with gold with a good weight that does not run. On large areas, it may be necessary to gild and fire twice. If you do have to do a second firing of the gold, do not burnish it in between. Special burnishing sand is used for the burnishing, but don't use too much pressure. An even movement and not much weight. The vase is now complete after 7 colour firings and 2 gold firings and about 47 hours painting. Have a good rest before starting on its pair.